to drum up support for the Resolution 342. That resolution calls for the end to the FDA's ban on estriol, which is a vital ingredient in some compounded bioidentical hormone treatments for women. Dr. Elizabeth Vaughn is here now to talk more about this. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you, Cindy?
I'm good. We first talked about this a couple months ago, right here. And when you talked about it before, whoever would have thought it would have come to this?
Oh, nobody did. I talked to several compounding pharmacists before that Fox 8 show, and none of them thought it would come to this. They assured me that there was no precedent for the FDA to ban estriol. It's in the United States Pharmacopeia, which means any physician in the country can prescribe it, and we have for over 30 years, and there's never been a problem with using it.
So there's no precedent set?
No.
Wow.
No precedent. It's never been done before. If the FDA's action is allowed to stand, it would force hundreds of thousands of women off of medications that their doctors have prescribed for them and for no scientific or medical reason.
So what are the issues with it?
Well, first, patients must have choices in their treatment. I have menopausal women who have felt miserable on ready-made drugs like Premarin. When the mass-manufactured medications fail them, they look for other alternatives, and frequently they get their lives back using weaker natural estrogens like estriol.
Is it better than the ready-made drugs?
No, not necessarily. However, there's a population of patients for whom mass-marketed drugs aren't effective or actually dangerous. These patients may be allergic to the dye in the pill. They may have an unusual genetic makeup, making them more sensitive to standard doses. The variations are endless. Each variation calls for a specific approach for each patient, and you have to have you can't use a cookie-cutter approach.
Right, one size fits all. Well, right. What can people do if they want to get involved?
Well, contact your congressman and ask them to support Resolution 342. Ask them to reverse the FDA's action before countless women suffer the hardship and inconvenience of being denied access to medications that have been prescribed for them by their doctors.
All right. Well, the good news is you can ask Dr. Vaughn more about this. We have more information about this on a morning news page of our website. And coming up, Dr. Vaughn will answer your questions when it is your turn. Our phone lines will open up in just a few minutes.
Great.
Thanks so much.